It's the final road trip of the season for the Florida State Seminoles as they take on the Maryland Terrapins at high noon on Saturday inside of Byrd Stadium. Welcome to your game preview presented by Best Buy. I'm Ryan Pensy. Florida State coming off of an exciting win over the Virginia Tech Hokies last Thursday night. The Seminoles have to put that win behind them and get ready for an exciting game against the Maryland Terrapins, who, record apart, are going to give the Seminoles one heck of a fight.
They have a great defense. You know, they work good together. You know, they run some the same kind of things, you know, our defense runs. So, you know, we face that every day. We face that all year. So, you know, it's something that we're familiar with. We just go out there and try to execute.
We just got to come out there and just play. You know, they're going to blitz us. They're going to try to do everything that Virginia Tech did. And what we got to learn from what we did in the Virginia Tech game against the running. Basically we got to do.
It's a big challenge just knowing they have guys that have been hurt. But we know every week, the team we play gonna give us their A game, so we just gotta come out ready to play.
Very important, cause you know a lot of people trying to get us to look ahead to Florida on next week and stuff like that, and the ACC championship. But this game right here is what we're gonna have to, you know, bog down and say we gotta win this one right here. We gotta still take it one game at a time. And I feel like really today at practice, everybody showed that, like, we're not even talking about other teams and next week and this and that. We just really talking about Maryland and what they're doing and how we can get better with them.
Getting outside of the friendly confines of Doak Campbell Stadium has been a challenge for the Florida State Seminoles this year. And one thing that the Noles would like to do as they cap off the 12-13 season is to have a complete game start to finish on the road.
It's another step in maturing. We trying to be a mature team. I mean, we all have that confidence when we're here in Doak, but we also got to be dominant on the road and, you know, set the tone in other people's houses and take the field. And that's what we kind of struggled this year doing. You know, for what reason, I don't know why. We just have to mature at that level.
If you haven't been paying attention, the Maryland Terrapins will be starting a linebacker at quarterback this week, as the Terrapins have been ravaged in their quarterback core. All of that aside, Randy Edsall knows that his team must play a perfect game to have a shot against the vaunted Florida State defense.
You know, the biggest thing we've got to do is not turn it over and be efficient with what we're doing and make sure that we allow Sean to be able to have time to throw the football, that we've got to be able to run the ball. And then defensively, you know, they're very talented. They got talented wide receivers. They got talented running backs. E.J. Manuel is as good a quarterback as there is. And then in special teams, they're talented as well. So the biggest thing is we can't make mistakes.
Joined now by Seminoles.com, Brandon Miller. Brandon, one of the keys this season all along has been not looking past games. You know, there's a lot, I guess, that the Seminoles could be looking forward to. They could win an ACC Atlantic Division title spot. They could be looking ahead to Florida. They got to focus on Maryland this week.
They do, and you look at him, and you mentioned in this preview that you've got a guy who's a linebacker, a true freshman linebacker playing quarterback. He's wearing number 31. It's going to look really weird out there for the defense to play them. You know, not many people think that Maryland has much of a chance in this game. Florida State players can't think that way. They need to think that, hey, we got a tough opponent on the road, hostile environment, you know, however many fans are going to be there. They need to treat this as if it's a championship game, because a championship game trip is on the line. And the Noles are trying to get back to the ACC title game. Haven't been back there in a couple of years. Have only won the ACC once, you know, since they went to a title game in 05. A lot to play for the Noles, and they can't overlook this team at all.
You know, when talking with the coaches and players this week, they expect maybe some trickery from the Maryland Terrapins this week. They're running a little bit of wildcat, doing whatever they can offensively. Defensively, they may be the second best defense in the ACC behind Florida State.
Well, that's the thing nobody talks about. Everyone's talked about this linebacker turned quarterback from Maryland, and rightfully so. It's an interesting story. But Maryland's defense is really good. Got a really good front four up there. A lot of guys who can rush the passer, stop the run. Florida State's going to have some troubles, and they need to show some improvement from last week when they played a very good Virginia Tech defense, which blitzed a lot and gave them some real issues. Couldn't run the ball, that negative yardage we all know about. Florida State needs to improve on that and not overlook that defense from Maryland, because they're very good, as you said.
Well, Stephon Diggs, he could play anywhere in the country. He's just with the Maryland Terrapins now. Don't forget, Seminoles.com will have complete coverage from Byrd Stadium. Brandon Miller, Scott Kotick, and the entire crew from Seminoles.com will be in College Park, Maryland this Saturday for the Seminoles' final ACC road trip. You can also listen to the game on the Seminole IMG Sports Network. We'll have complete and comprehensive coverage after the game as well on Seminoles.com. During the game, Seminoles.com/gameday is your home for all of the information that you'll need to follow the Seminoles and the Terrapins. For Seminoles.com, I'm Ryan Pensy.